So, Bhagavan means the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Absolute truth is realized in three phases. Brahmeti, Paramatmeti, Bhagavaniti Sabdate. Absolute truth can be realized in the beginning as impersonal Brahma, which is the objective of the jnanis, and next Paramatma, which is the objective of the yogis, and at last, the last word in the absolute understanding is person, the Supreme Personality of God. The ultimate issue is the Supreme Personality of God, just like we understand that in the sun globe there is the Supreme Person or the Surya Narayan or the chief person within the sun planet. His name is also given in the Bhagavad Gita, Vivasan. The Lord says in the fourth chapter, Imam Vivasati Jugam Pratavan Ahamabhayam. I first of all explain this science, this yoga system of Bhagavad Gita to Vivasan, the sun god. Vivasan Manove Prahu Manu Ikha Kave Bravi. And Vivasan, the sun god, he explained to Mano, and Mano explained to his son. In this way, by the disciplic succession, the knowledge has come down. So when we speak of jnana, knowledge, it must be learned from a person. So Bhagavan, the last word in the understanding of Absolute Truth, he says in this Bhagavad Gita. Vasudeva specifically means here Bhagavan Uvacha. He does not say Krishna Uvacha, because sometimes Krishna is misunderstood by the fools. So, Bhagavan Uvacha, this word means whatever he says, there is no defect or deficiencies. For ordinary person like us, there are four defects: Brahm, Pramad, Vipralipsa, Karanapat. In the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, or self-realized person, servants of Krishna, those who have understood Krishna, for them there are no deficiencies, they are perfect. For this reason, Krishna gives the instruction, tadviddhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya upadakshanti tadgyanam jnanina tattva-darshina. One who has actually seen or actually realized the truth, you have to take knowledge from there. So we have to approach such person. Otherwise, if we approach some speculator, we cannot get real knowledge. So those who are speculators, they cannot understand what is God. Therefore, they commit mistake that God is like this, God like that, there is no God, there is no form. All these nonsense things are proposed because they are imperfect. Bhagavan therefore says, apajananti mangamurha manusim tanumatra, because he comes for our benefit in the human form. The fools and rascals consider him as ordinary person. If Bhagavan says, Aham bija pada pita, I am the seed-giving father. So, every one of us we know that my father is person, his father is person, his father is person, and why the supreme person or the supreme father should become impersonal? Why? And therefore, we have to learn from Bhagavan, the supreme person, full knowledge. This Bhagavad Gita is therefore full knowledge from the full personality of God. We cannot change even one word in this Bhagavad Gita. That is folly. So our this Krishna consciousness movement is following this principle. We don't manufacture any concocted things. We simply distribute the message given by the Supreme Personality of God. And this is becoming effective practically.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Krishna.